All right, the end step behind you. Today we're going to kick off. Today will be a little bit lighter in language arts. We're going to do a couple cat clips, some real life cat stories, and then a debate. So hands off your Chromebook, a little break from screen fatigue is real, so get you off your screens. But the central question, the issue, should the Harrods have returned Oscar? Should we sacrifice our personal happiness for the good of others? You know, in the end, is it better to have loved and lost than to have never loved? And if you have any time, you can continue working on your character traits if those aren't yet done. This year, PBS came out with All Creatures Great and Small, and it was a fantastic season. And right now, they're currently filming season 2. So it's a story of Dr. Harriet. There he is, and he's working. He was hired by Dr. Farnan as a veterinary assistant. So it's the beginning of his veterinary career, and he has to move up to Yorkshire and the Dales, which are rolling hills in this countryside, being a farm doctor. And there's Tristan, which will eventually be his future assistant, and they'll work together for many years. So just wanted to show you the trailer of this season, and then you can find it on Amazon.
Got an interview.
Yorkshire?
Excuse me, this is Derby, isn't it?
I'd almost given up on you. I'm Mrs. Orr. I keep house for Mr. Farnan.
I'm Farnan, Siegfried. New assistant. Oh, aye, another one. Mr. Farnan's new assistant.
Another one.
Let's talk forward.
I've got a gelding gone wrong in hoof.
Well, we certainly don't want that.
I've dealt with many horses before.
This will be my first.
Pick my brother up from the station. He should be on the 4:30.
How'd you find him? My brother, I mean.
He's not without his inconsistencies.
Inconsistencies? The man's a lunatic.
Blimey.
Quite something, isn't it?
That's no way to greet Mr. Harriet. You are a handsome devil.
Can I see you sometime? I'm sorry, I shouldn't have.
It's not that, it's just...
This is where you're hiding. Who's this?
James Harriet.
Harriet!
Siegfried's bark really is worse than his bite. Underneath it all, he's a good man. Stand up to him. He'll love you for it.
Up in the Dales, surrounded by those hills. There's no place on earth like it.
Careful. Once it gets in your bones, it's hard to get out.
I'm not sure I want it to.
And so you're going to pause my video and you're going to go to slide 2, teachers, and there's two stories. One is a cat making his way back to his owners, much like our story. And the other one is this guy, he's a true life adventure and all the cool places that he and his cat go. So enjoy these two clips and I'll meet you back after that. Okay, so we wanted to get you off your screens as much as possible today. And so teachers, you can pass out this handout. And it's, should the Harriets have returned Oscar is at the top. And we're going to list our reasons back and forth. So pause if you need to be able to distribute this to the kids. Otherwise, I'll continue on. So the Harriets, they sacrificed their personal happiness. They experienced a lot, great deal of pain and heartache from giving Oscar back. This cat they had invested in and who's become ensconced into their own family life and household and very much a pillar of the community and the whole, you know, little village loves this guy. And yet, you know, it came up with a lot of distress from giving. Should they have done that, right? And so here, I want you to take some personal time, just paper, pencil, and just think right here. Reasons, yes, they needed to. I mean, think about those two. Tiger, oh, Tiger, right? The history that family has, the family not having much, right? I don't want to give away answers or steer your thunder. So go ahead and put yes. Put as many reasons that you can think of. But then I want you to do some divergent thinking. Even if you don't agree with this side, I want you to go to the other side and also come up with reasons and look at the issue from multiple perspectives. The Harriets should not return Oscar. They should have kept him, right? I mean, Dr. Harriet investing in this life-saving surgery for this cat, with no benefit other than just, you know, the purrs and the joy this cat added. He wasn't paid for this, yet he did it. Come up with as many reasons as you can, okay? So give students 5-10 minutes to do that. Once done, find a podmate, compare lists, combine, right? So take from each other and then fill out, flesh out your list for all your reasons. And then I would love for you to have a whole crew debate. Yes versus no. And usually we're very divided on this. Some people saying, why he absolutely had every right to stake a claim on that cat. And then why not? Why he did do the right thing in returning him. Okay. After your debate, you will go ahead and put your final conclusion statement. Should you need more space, you may use the back, but your personal conclusion, what you feel they should have done and why. And I'd just love for you to have like two reasons there, your strongest reasons on whether they did or did not do the right thing. So just to recap, on your own thinking, yes and no. Podmate thinking, join forces and add more, yes or no. Whole crew, debate. And at the end, your little exit ticket is your personal conclusion surrounding the issue in this story, right? We love to lift up literature to our own lives and kind of take a pulse on our own moral compass and see how we fit with what the characters have done and decided to do. Do we agree? All right. And then once done, you may turn this into your crew teacher, and that's it. Should you need to have more time with your character traits, again, that look like this, just coming up with a trait for each character, for James, for Helen, for Oscar, and the Gibbons family, those will be due tomorrow. So thanks so much for your work today, and we'll see you next time.